And we are live here from the BB Holiday Tournament, where your Vilani Eagles are going to play the Little Rock Southwest Griffins. Your Eagles come to this ball game, you know, off of a tough loss to the Maumelle Hornets, you know, one you would not like to see. It was just a tough Maumelle team, and, you know, they had a lot of good size. And, you know, Austin, what else do you think the Eagles have to do today to not lose this Little Rock Southwest team?
Well, number one, the first thing, we actually played this team before, played them in the V-Town Showdown, took care of business against them. But the thing that happened in that game, we connected a lot from three. They came out in a 2-3 zone against us, and Jones White lit them up for 15 in the first quarter.
Yes.
And then they face guarded him the rest of the game.
Yes.
So I would say when in doubt, I would be surprised to see him come out in the zone. I would say kind of need to figure out what defense they're going to come out in to start the game is going to be a key. I don't think they'll come out in the zone. They do. That's kind of bold considering the last one.
Yes.
But number two, got to be able to hit some threes.
Yes, and I think, you know, another thing is they're going to key in on Jones White. So I think we have to swing the ball to Deshaun Spence or Ethan Dietz because they're going to be – they have the size advantage. They have more strength than these Little Rock Southwest bigs. I think we just have to bully them around in the paint, and I think we'll win this ball game.
And with Day, Little Rock Southwest does have some size here that they didn't have in that first matchup, so that could cause a little bit of issue for Spence and Dietz. But you also add in the factor of Dietz being able to shoot from outside, spread the floor.
Yes.
Spence, we'd like to see him maybe go inside more. I agree with you. Let's try to get some plays to set up Spence in the post. He's tough to stop down there one-on-one. Get that matchup as much as you can and play off of that. Play through White and Spence, and you could have a pretty successful game plan.
Here's a bold take I have. I think Ethan Dietz is probably one of the best shooters, best big men shooters in the 5A right now. He's done a really good job shooting basketball.
I think that's a really good take.
So it's not bold?
No, it's not. It is in fact, terrific.
Terrific. You know, I think also Kate Smith-Hart, he's going to have a good game today on the defensive side of the basketball. He's really going to shut down number double zero, Kingston Alexander today, I believe.
Yeah, pretty much him and I forget who it was. I think it was number two for Southwest.
Yes,
I think it was
number two.
Alexander. Those two really controlled the pace for Southwest in that first matchup. And we had Harrison Lane on. We had Smith-Hart all on them just trying to get a hand in their face because we know they're going to try to create. So
yes.
That's something you want to see from Smith-Hart. Had the defense get in their face. We got to remember, Smith-Hart also dealt with a lot of foul trouble in the last game.
Yes.
Barely even got to play because he fouled out in like maybe 5 minutes played. So as long as we have pressure defense from him and along with some of the other guards coming off the bench, should be pretty good on the defensive end for the Eagles.
And you got to know, Josh Lawrence probably going to get the start today, that two-guard position. He's going to be a really good slasher. He didn't start against the Southwest in the B-Town Showdown, so they're not really used to seeing him. So I think he's going to do a really good job today. Attacking the basket and just being athletic as he is. He's one of the most athletic people you can see on the floor, and he's just a great guy to watch.
Yeah, I mean, you talk about his speed. We talked about it multiple times. Whenever he gets on a fast break, he gets the rebound. Good luck stopping him coast to coast. He has that type of speed. And like I said, he's got that vertical ability too. We've
yes.
seen him we haven't seen him dunk this year, but we know he has an ability to dunk. So that's something to keep an eye out for, him getting in transition. And he's also, in the last couple games, gotten more going on some of his jump shots, too. So getting him going could also be another big key for the Eagles here today.
He has a nice little mid-range pull-up jumper. And he can just pull up and just hang in the air and like, oh, you're going to go down to the ground. I'm going to stay in here and I'm going to shoot it.
It's like he freezes in the air.
He freezes time when he's in the air.
Freezes time.
Well, we got 2 minutes and 55 seconds here until the tip-off. Still warm-ups going on. Austin, do you have anything else to say?
Not much besides another thing. With their bigs coming back, we got to be able to rebound. That's the thing we've
yes.
seen at times. The Eagles struggle a bit with rebounding because sometimes it's just one guy crashing the boards and multiple players crashing for the opposing team.
Yes.
So we got to be able to box out and not give them second chance points because that's being the Eagles in some games this year.
Yes, and you can't just like rely on Ethan Dietz and Deshaun Spence to get those rebounds. Yes, they are great rebounders in their own right, but if you have a Jones White, a Josh Lawrence crash in there, Josh Lawrence can outjump anybody in this gym, probably other than Deshaun Spence. So I think if you can just have everybody crash the boards, we can get the rebounds, we can run and gun, we can win this ball game.
Exactly.
Grant, let's take a GNL Financial.
Playing a team sport takes hard work, dedication, and mental toughness. When the game clock is ticking down, you need a coach to help you stay focused on what matters and tune out the noise. For years, Vilonia Basketball has worked to build a legacy helping students develop skills that will help them through life. Whether on the court or on the road to financial independence, persistence toward your goal is key. I'm Chad Roller with Genwell Financial Advisors. Whether you're just starting out or the final seconds are ticking away toward retirement, we're here to help you. Go Eagles!
Thank you for your business.
And we are back here in BB where the Blown Eagles are going to take on Little Rock Southwest Griffins. Eagles wearing all white today, nice white uniforms. Also have new shooting shirts, I think. Say family on the front.
And they have their names on the back. Now, I may be mistaken, but I think one of the purposes of a shooting shirt is they're not looking at your numbers, knowing who you are while you're warming up.
Yes.
That doesn't match this, though.
Number 00, Kingston Alexander to come out of the shoot for the Griffins first. And the number 1, a sophomore, number 1, Jonathan Hudson. Number 2, Robert Alexander. He's a senior this year. Number 3, Corbin Page. He's a sophomore. And a junior, number 12, Samuel Meredith. That'll be the starting lineup for the Little Rock Southwest Griffins. And now for the Bologna Eagles starting lineup. First out, a senior, number 3, Jones White.
He's going to have to play a great game today.
Junior, number 10, Josh Lawrence, next out. Next out, Ethan Dietz, also a junior. And the 3 juniors, last of them, number 22, Deshaun Spence. And Lane Turner getting the start today, number 25.
And I like it. Get a little bit more height in there. He can create as well.
And that dude can float, too.
Yes.
He can get up there, and that's something a lot of people don't realize about his game. That guy is going to put his eyes above the rim.
Yes, and another update on the girls. They will play at 5:30 tomorrow here in BB. They'll play the winner of Harding Academy and Searcy. That game will happen at 4 o'clock today.
You know, my pick there is Harding Academy.
Yes, they're a very tough girls team. They almost beat our Lady Eagles. So
yeah, provided a good challenge for them earlier this year. So if we do play them again, Lady Eagles know they're going to be in for a battle.
I'm excited to see the Earl game against either Searcy or Harding Academy, though. I think Earl is going to step up.
Yes. Kind of rebound here from the game, previous game against the Lady Eagles. Sean Spence gets the tip. Over number 12, Samuel Meredith. Jones White will bring the ball up the floor. Gets to Lawrence on the right wing. Back to White.
And it looks like they are coming out in that 2-3 zone.
White to Turner, down to Spence. Spence up. Good float game, up and in. Good job by Deshaun Spence there.
Yeah, he hung in the air just long enough to get the shot up, clear of any defenders.
Alexander down to Meredith. Over to 1, Jonathan Hudson. Now back up to Kingston Alexander. Over to Hudson. Now back up to Robert Alexander. And over to Kingston Alexander. Shot no good by Hudson. Rebound, White.
Good job by Dietz there.
Yeah, he lifts weights.
Yes. Jones White bringing the ball off the floor. Gives it to Lawrence. Lawrence skips it over to White. Can't leave him open. That's a 3 for Jones White, and that is good.
And you would think that they would learn from that. Like you said, 15-point first quarter last time against them, giving him a wide-open look like that.
Southwest pushing the basketball with Robert Alexander. Shot up no good. Rebound, Ethan Dietz.
Yeah, you've got to think Southwest is on the other side saying, oh, no, it's starting again.
Spence thought about the 3, drives in, over to Dietz in the corner, back up to White, to the corner to Lawrence. Lawrence drives baseline, floats up, and in.
That's what you want Josh Lawrence to do. That's why he's on the floor. No one is stopping his drive.
Yes, quick timeout there by the Griffins, and we'll take a timeout with them with Bologna Realty.
Johnny and Jackie Falks own and operate Bologna Realty alongside their children with over a century of combined real estate experience. Located at 1037 Main Street across from Centennial Bank, Bologna Realty is dedicated to offering professional, knowledgeable, and confidential services to all of our clients. We are proud to partner with our community while offering full-service real estate throughout the Central Arkansas area. This includes homes, land, and commercial property. Call Jackie or Johnny, Jill Bonema, or Jared Falks at 501-796-8530.
I'm Brian Lane. Lane Family Dentistry has been serving the dental needs of Bologna for over 18 years. I live in the community, my kids go to school here in the district, and my family also attends church in Bologna. This is my home.
At Lane Family Dentistry, we provide many services such as Botox, dermal fillers, aligners to straighten teeth, implants, tooth whitening, and smile makeovers. We also treat sleep apnea. Call Lane Family Dentistry. We are a proud supporter of the Bologna Eagles. Go Eagles!
And we are back here in BB where Robert Alexander swings it up to number three, Corbin Page. Page down to Robert Alexander. Great chirping there by the Eagles bench. Makes that shot go offline. Rebound Dietz.
And again, like we kind of talked about, Graham, we're still kind of surprised they came out in that 2-3 zone, especially now it's kind of like a 1-2-2 here. Or they're having an extended, they're extending out Alexander here maybe.
Jones White to Lawrence. Lawrence to Lane Turner. Over to White. White for three. Can't leave him open again. No good. Rebound Lawrence. Lawrence to Deshaun Spence. Spence up no good.
Great pass by Lawrence. The bounce pass inside.
Robert Alexander pushing the pace. Down to number 12, Samuel Meredith, and that layup is up and good.
And that's the thing in the first matchup. Southwest loves to push it whenever they get the chance.
Spence push the pace. Now slow it down. Lane Turner in the corner for three. No good. Good steal there by Lane Turner. Jones White up to Josh Lawrence. Lawrence drives baseline, backs it out. Skip pass to Ethan Dietz to Lane Turner. Now back to Dietz for three. No good. Rebound White. Great job to crash the boards there.
You talked about that in the pregame.
White's for three. White for three, and that is good.
The board all the way back out for an easy three-point shot. That's exactly what you were looking for, Connor, in the pregame.
Yes, all over the place is Jones White right now. Number three, Corbin Page with the shot, no good. Tipped around, rebound by Spence.
That's the thing with Southwest offense. Really don't run a lot of set plays. They really try to get a lot of good looks really quickly.
White with the ball, top of the key, guarded by Kingston Alexander.
You've got to be curious if they could look to face guard Jones here, as they did for almost the entire game in the first matchup.
Lawrence to Spence. Spence pull-up jumper, no good. The rebound by Meredith. Alexander in the lane, out to another Alexander, and back to Alexander. Two different Alexanders on this team. Kingston Alexander, number 00, and number 2, Robert Alexander. Number 3, Corbin Page driving through. Gets blocked by Lane Turner. Rebound by Dietz.
Good job by Turner using his hands, using his length.
Lawrence pushing the ball up the floor. Over to Turner, over to White in the corner. White drives baseline. Skip pass over to Dietz in the corner. Dietz for three. Yes, sir. He got that one to go.
And again, when it comes to this zone, if the Eagles are knocking down threes, they're going to have to definitely get out of the zone, or this is going to get out of hand.
Robert Alexander in the lane. Layup up and good. What a fancy layup there by Robert Alexander. Pushing the pace is the Eagles up to Josh Lawrence.
Right now, we're really creating through wide. We're just looking to attack and kick it outside, getting some really good looks from three here early.
Lawrence over to Spence, top of the key. Dietz has a mismatch, couldn't get to him. Now they get it down to Dietz. Skip pass over to Lane Turner, back up to Josh Lawrence for three. No good. Good tip-in, almost tip-in by Lane Turner, and ultimately turns into a Deshaun Spence tip-in.
Yeah, high effort plays there by Spence as well as Turner. Turner just didn't quite roll in. Spence right there to finish the job.
Robert Alexander guarded by Dietz. So swings it to Kingston Alexander for three, and he got it.
Like Scotty Thurman on that shot. He got it way up there.
Jones-White getting into lane. Two-pointer up, no good. Good job by Deshaun Spence to out-jump everybody there. Ball's tipped around. Josh Lawrence, floater up and in.
Offensive rebounds will win you a lot of basketball games. Right now it's helping out the Eagles in a big way.
Robert Alexander was fouled by Jones-White there. Maybe a little push, they think, by Jones-White.
Here comes McKissick.
Weston McKissick, an All-State quarterback, checking into the ball game.
Looks like Dietz will take a break.
Also new in for the Griffins, number five, Torio Baker. Baker will get the ball over to Robert Alexander. Alexander drives, pulls up, got it to go.
It's a pretty shot.
Yes, great shot there by Robert Alexander.
Now you're going to see a lot of shots like that in the 5A Central for the Eagles. I think this is a good game getting ready for the rest of conference play.
Spence in the lane, up and in.
That's just simple right there. Just simple pick and roll, two tall players. Create a mismatch.
Kingston Alexander floats it up, no good. Rebound, Robert Alexander, blocked by Lane Turner.
Great block by Turner there.
Samuel Merritt tries to dunk it. It'll get blocked by Spence. White pushing over to McKissick. McKissick lays it, no good. Rebound, Lawrence. And tipping is no good.
Yeah, you do not dunk on Deshaun Spence. That just will not happen.
I don't even know. He actually thought about dunking on him. Who would have thought that?
He jumped from way out.
Did you read the scouting report? Did you read the scouting report?
Yeah, based on where he jumped.
Jim is dead silent on that free throw.
I think it's almost more difficult to score a free throw in a silent gym than it is one that's yelling at you.
I could agree.
Second free throw for Lawrence is good. Went one for two on that trip. And number 13, Trelon Dixon will check into the ball game for the Griffins. A check in for Kingston Alexander. Alexander over to Dixon. Dixon to Baker. Baker driving. Back out to Robert Alexander. Alexander. Number one, Jonathan Hudson. Hudson up, no good. Rebound fighting for it is Josh Lawrence. It'll be a held ball. I think it'll remain Southwest's ball there.
And we're seeing some good minutes here from McKissick, too, getting, of course, the former football player we talked about,
right.
The All-State QB.
Yeah.
Robert Alexander, step back three, up, and good.
And that's what he can do. He did that in the first matchup. He looked to create, try to get that separation on the step back.
And it's a heads-up play there by Jones-White.
That was a really heads-up play.
Let the ball roll, and then let the shot clock go off. That way they can have the last shot.
Really smart play by Jones-White there. That's that senior leadership right there.
Corner to Lawrence. Lawrence drives baseline up. No good, but there was some contact. No good foul call.
You know, that's a nice, strong move to the basket there by Lawrence. Of course, you would have liked to see it fall, but you're not always going to get it to go. It's a good way to draw a foul.
Lawrence, first free throw is up and good. There's a decent amount of people in this gym, but it's really silent, Grant.
Yeah, it's almost eerie. How quiet it can get.
Eerie like Corey Eerie?
Yeah, just like him.
Second free throw up and good for Lawrence. Robert Alexander looks to push the pace. Alexander gives it. Oh, gave it to number one, Jonathan Hudson, but the time expires so he can throw it up. Austin, why don't we talk about some of our sponsors here?
Centennial Bank, DNN Construction, our Platinum Eagle sponsors, Countryside Motors, HSA Engineering, Lane Family Dentistry, and Genwell Financial. Other Platinum Eagle sponsors, Reed's, Sims Electric, Linda Marie's, Bologna Therapy Services, and Bologna Realty. Gold Eagle sponsors, Arkansas Warriors, B&B Sliding and Windows, Bologna Family Pharmacy, Simon Roofing and Restoration. And our Silver Eagle sponsors, Harps, J.C. Thornton, Simple Simon's Pizza, Infinity Hair, Sue Shock Insurance, and Around the Table. And once again, a thank you to our 2022-2023 sponsors. But yeah, really good for offensive first quarter, wouldn't you say, Connor?
Yes, it was a great job by the Bologna Eagles. You know, getting some threes up. You had Ethan Dietz and Jones White. Jones White had two threes in that quarter. And Ethan Dietz also had one as well.
Guys, I may be mistaken here, but is John Cena in the building?
It sounds like John Cena is in the building.
I don't know. I can't see him.
Yeah, I know you can't see him.
But it sounds like it.
You can hear him.
You truly can. We got to be careful. He might have gone onto the court. We don't know.
Eagles start with the ball this quarter. Wide over to Lane Turner. Turner over to White. Turner down to Spence. Spence over the corner to McKissick. McKissick for three. Got it.
That's what he does.
Wesley McKissick with a three-point shot.
Corner three like his name's Peter Griffin.
That
very
pass
well
stolen
placed
by
there,
Lawrence. Lawrence driving up. No good. Tipped around. It'll stay Eagles basketball.
You thought he might throw it up to Lane Turner there, maybe
yes.
Even Wesley McKissick. I don't dislike the choice to try to score it yourself there. Just had some options. That was one of them.
Lawrence driving. Good pass.
Nice
to Spence.
Pass.
And a ferocious dunk by Deshaun Spence.
Yeah, Spence says that's how you dunk.
Number 12, Samuel Meredith, trying to take some notes there on the sideline about that dunk. Great defense by the Eagles as Wes McKissick steals it from number three. That'll be Corbin Page, but I believe it'll remain. No, it'll actually be Eagles basketball.
Yeah, McKissick was all over that defensively as Nolan checks in. Lane Turner taking a break.
White to McKissick, over to Nolan in the corner. Nolan looking for Spence, couldn't get it to him. Lawrence driving. Gives to White in the corner. You got to guard him. Misses that one. That's a rare miss by Jones White. Robert Alexander pushing the pace. Pull-up jumper is no good. Rebound White. White is all over the place today, Grant.
Yeah, he really is. And one thing he's doing really well is slowing this game down. The Eagles like to control the pace as best they can. Southwest clearly wants to run. Bologna just not allowing it.
White top of the key with the basketball. Over to Nolan. Good pass out to Spence. Spence. Over to Lawrence. Lawrence shot fake. Driving. Pull-up jumper. No good. Good rebound by Corbin Page there. Robert Alexander pushing it. Nolan tried to set up for the charge. Couldn't get it, and that's a foul on Wesley McKissick. Never mind. I actually give it to Nolan.
Okay. But now, Grant, you pointed out Jones Whiteshop slowing it down. Again, that's that senior leadership, that play at the end of the first quarter. He's got so many things locked to his mind, being that leader and, of course, playing basketball for so many years.
That first free throw was up and good for Robert Alexander.
You know, the Eagles are really fortunate to have several bigs that are capable of playing at a high level. Ethan Dietz able to check in for Deshaun Spence. And it's not really a drop-off. Of course, Dietz isn't going to cock it back and throw it down or anything.
But he also gives something different compared to Spence. That's also that three-point ability.
Yeah, the three-point. And he's still such a strong rebounder and great paint defender. just a great, great thing to have for Coach Troy Campbell.
Sather to White. White dribble around the top of the key over to Nolan. Nolan dribbles into the lane. Gets it tipped away. Robert Alexander will push the pace. Tim and Corbin Page as he goes up over Ethan Dietz and tip in by number three, Corbin Page.
That's the thing again, Southwest, and again, Jones going to try to slow it down a bit here. While track meets, the Eagles can win those. They know they're at their best when they control the pace of the game.
Yeah, the Eagles know a thing or two about track meets.
They've won a lot of them.
Yes.
That is true.
Jones White will be running the 800 this year, I believe, for the track team. Rebound, Corbin Page. He'll push the pace by himself. Pull-up jumper is no good. Good rebound by McKissick. White up to Sather. First action we've seen of Sather today. Sather driving through the lane. Gives it to Nolan. Nolan in the lane over to White. McKissick to Sather. Sather pulls up for three, and that's good. Good three-point shot there by Riley.